Hello all, in this video we are going to see how to use Google Scholar effectively. Google Scholar is a research database having more articles that to freely available articles compared to PubMed. The main disadvantage of Google Scholar is the standards of these articles will be less compared to that of the PubMed indexed ones. In this video, I am going to show how Google Scholar can be effectively used. I am going to mention three important uses of Google Scholar. That is, number one is the review of literature. You can make a good review of literature through Google Scholar, before which we should understand about the Boolean logics. The commonly used Boolean terms are AND, OR and NOT. So AND means if you are giving two terms and incorporating AND between that terms, then it will show only articles having both the terms. If you are incorporating R to two terms, then it will show articles containing either of those terms. If you are showing NOT, then the search engine shows articles without that term. Suppose if you are typing coronary heart disease and giving a search here, then there will be nearly 26,50,000 articles. And if you want to add R coronary artery disease, then the search number will increase to 34.5 lakhs. But if you want to exclude congenital from those articles, then if you type congenital, then your articles will be restricted to only 19,000. So in such way, we can refine our articles and we can do further refining in respect to the time here. If this is your parent article, then you want exactly similar articles to this, then you just click on this related articles. You will get articles exactly related to that. The second main use of Google Scholar is citing the article. That is, when you are looking for some article here, there will be a cite symbol or quote symbol will appear here. If you click on this symbol, then a dialog will appear like this. So from which you can manually export this citation for that specific article. You can also use BibTeX, EndNote, Reference Manager, RefWorks for directly exporting the citations. So I will show how you can do that. So if this is your article, you want to cite this particular article, if you click here, it will automatically appear here and you can select this article and you can manually do. The best way is not to do this. In case if you are doing an article with less than 20 references, you can prefer this manual referencing. Otherwise, it is always better to use Menly or Zotero or EndNote softwares for reference management. So here I am using Menly here. So the third main use of Google Scholar is the social networking. So these are all some of the examples of the social networking sites for academicians and researchers like LinkedIn, ResearchGate, Academia, Orchid, Menly. Same way, Google Scholar also provides social networking. That is, you can share your articles, you can get citation updates for your articles. So for this, you need to create your own profile and you need to upload your publications. The main important thing for this Google Scholar profile is you need an institutional email ID. I repeat, it is not the Gmail ID which you routinely use. It is the institutional email ID. Mostly it will end in .edu or ac.in or .gov and so on. So here you can look at the articles and how many citations per year. All these things you can track with your co-authors, you can interact. So all these things can be done with Google Scholar. So the three uses of Google Scholar are to do a thorough review of literature, whatever PubMed cannot give with the caution of the low standards in that journal, but most of the journals will be freely available. Second thing is we can do manual citations, and the third thing is social networking. Thanks for watching this video.